Yo, yo. Yo, yo. Let me know we've got a microphone. Bunny, as soon as I turn it on, just want to cough. So here we are. The sun also rises. What are we starting with? A 24 minutes at Le Mans is the next race. Be the fastest in a GR1 with GR4s on tracks. The course is narrow and there is a big difference between the cars. Even a small misjudgment can be catastrophic. Loopy is testing. So, yeah, the sun is rising. So almost the final mission challenges before we have to sit down and grind. The 1 hour challenges, yeah, they're going to be interesting, I think. Feel like we've been way too hesitant. Look at that, missed it by an absolute mile. What a killer. So we will have to push just a touch harder earlier by the looks of it. So were they all group four cars, I think? Just got to be committed, mate. Easy peasy, nice and simple like. Yeah, so where were we? It's Monday night. It's the correct night for all the changeover gear to happen, so we should see we'll see the new cars. What will it be? The new Legends cars, the new used cars, most of that stuff should be changing today, one would hope. Yeah, we've even got the daily race changeover, so we'll check that out. You can just run whatever car you like. Is that what it reckons, is it? Buy everything for this car. Hopefully we did. Yeah. Okay, that looks like it's got a decent top speed. We'll give it a thrash and see what happens. Can't remember how hard this one is. So I think we're going to scroll through a 24-hour race here. Probably get some weather and all that kind of jazz. One would expect. Yeah, my voice feels a little bit croaky. Don't remember doing anything that would wear it out. Clearly just didn't drink enough water or something today. Better check out the fuel situation. Make sure we don't burn too much of that crap. Might need to save a little bit of that. Need to stay out as long as we can. Brake 5, that's a bit exotic, isn't it? Throwing rear brakes that hard on. I we're still waiting for the May rumours. Would be good if they could time the new races to the start of the month. That would be good. Took them about, I think, took them 2 weeks to get the April update in, so one would assume we'll see something similar here. That track limits were monitored, but just 1 second, hopefully it doesn't mean much in the grand scheme of things, but we could be on the wrong tire as well. Not every day you see the Ford Mark IV around, so that is one of the platinum cars. If you're looking to platinum, you need to save up some money and get one of those bad boys under your belt. I'm definitely hoping the rain will bring us back into this race. Or maybe a fuel strat. Even though I think we're running not a lot of power, this car must have enough power in it. Just a casual AI block, no big deal. Anyone know who E. Scott is? Name I don't remember throwing around. Could be a 2018 Australian name. We're properly getting smoked now. More pens. Be interesting to see how many penalties we get for that. Yeah, shit tons. Cray cray. Might even have to clean up my driving standards. Not ideal. The weather's still fine. More track limits. Track limit there as well. We'll just get 25 seconds worth of track limits. Feels good. Still waiting for this rain to come to me. Absolutely smoking those tires. But we could go dark soon. I can't believe we chose the wrong race, wrong tire, like an absolute rookie. Hopefully we can make it work. Ferret, how are you doing, mate? How's your week? Tried to get hold of you over the weekend. Struggle to touch. Hundreds of seconds, Jerry, that one's going to be worth. Only half a second, probably definitely worth it. Probably saved about 5 seconds. He's been the scruffiest of scruffy laps. I'm not looking forward to doing this again if I stuff it up. So out to wrong tire choice could definitely hurt. Playing the long game already. What are we, one quarter through the race? Not ideal. Absolute bags of penalties. Oh, an absolute rookie life. So we'll try and keep this lap clean. But hard work gone. Definitely doesn't look like it's going to rain, does it? I just don't want to be the guy that comes in. Oh, I love that. Look at night. See the flames? Just... can we get one more lap out of it? Gonna have to, I think. Absolutely losing time to the leaders like it's going out of fashion. That feels like an awfully slow lap. I was hoping there'd be blokes pitting by now. You'd almost have to do like a hard no stop. Should have just brought the Tomahawk out and destroyed it, I think. Oh, there's the rain. Maybe I'll be saved. Still got a long way to get there though. Hopefully all the blokes hit the picks. Maybe that is what happens. That's nothing on the radar, the game-changing radar. But definitely, oh, there we go, look at that. A little bit of moisture. They should still be right for slicks. Definitely that first full bar is drying or dampening track. Look at that, it fast makes its way up to the intermediate sector. Rain got a little bit heavier. Yeah, look at that, it was definitely time for inters. Just in time, I don't know how we made that. Oh, that's exactly what I didn't need. Oh, that is killer. Oh, cheers, mate. These blokes, I don't even know which way I'm facing. Yeah, not that way. That is going to be, what gear am I in? Yeah, not only is it dark, I'm on the wrong tire. It only started raining as soon as I passed pit lane. I'm getting absolutely murdered for it. We are on worn out softs. Oh, are we even going to make it back to the pit? Now that's gone to full wets now. We're 2.5 minutes off the leaders. The leaders have already changed to the correct tyre. I cannot see me winning this. This is so sad. 24 minutes of my life gone. Do we throw the race in the bin and restart, or do we... We're miles from home. Yeah, I swear last time it rained before I got to the pits. This time it started raining as soon as I drove past them. Those guys must be on the same tyres. 3 minutes behind the leaders now, just can't see me catching that. Three and a half minutes now. Going to be the most painful start to a stream I've ever done this race, I think. Absolutely killing me. Should have just brought the Tomahawk out. Got it done. Now the big question here is, the full wet. Like, do I go straight to a wet or do I go to intermediate? Because it's right on the second line now. Might go the inter. Inter in a full tank and somehow I've got to make it the remaining 10 minutes of this race while catching up 4 minutes. Most painful thing I've ever done. Oh yeah, rain's coming, going. So we'll definitely go to the intermediate. 16th. We've lost the world's most amount of time. So sort of upset right now. Where's the pit lane entrance? Is it going to stop raining? I have to gamble on it stop raining, don't I? We'll go to hards and a full tank, and then I have to drive all the way home. Then pray that that was the one lap of rain. Otherwise, yeah, and then hope that they all are on the wrong tyre and they have to stop. Or otherwise, we're restarting. Yeah, tell me about it, Ferbs. It's so frustrating. Yeah. Good. Come on, son. See how it's dawn already? Maybe I do have to bring out an LMP1 car here. We are a long way off the pace. I'm done. Start again. Where's car selection? Let's run what you brung, eh? so we can race any of these bad boys. We could take out the XJR. Could even take out the 787. I probably don't own all this, all everything I need for this. No, I definitely don't. So we need to choose. How do I own everything? Change. Living Legend, maybe? Ah, I only own one thing for that as well. I clearly haven't done any of this stuff before. Okay, so we're gonna have to. Oh, daily workout. Cheers, bro. So we're gonna have to get a Group 1 car, I think. It's arrive. Better go check the Legends car, see if there's anything worth buying and setting up. Legends cars. So this week's Legends, what do we got to choose from? There we go. That's a nice car. Porsche. Sounds alright. That was something I wouldn't mind modifying. Jack, how are you, mate? Yeah, just had to bail on the 24 minutes of Le Mans because I clearly chose the wrong car, but we're going to get the right car now. So that's a new one. Sort of new, but not really, I think. So Corvette Stingray. Nothing changing over tonight, although the GDR and the Superbird have gone to limited stock, so they should be sold out tomorrow. Any decent used cars, that is the question. I think they've moved all these swap overs to Tuesdays. Oh, here we go. Even got a little new tag. That makes it a bit quicker. So you can see what's new since the last time you came in. Not game changing by any means, but not too bad. Head to the tuning shop and get some of the gear we need. Selection of regular tires. Should we grab while we're there? That. Buy these for future, especially if we're going to stay in the Porsche for long term. Nothing worse than not having it when you need it. And we get a bigger turbo. Can try that. Manual. There should be a fully racing manual yet. We'll try that. Stuff. A little bit of nitrous, because you never know when you're going to need to cheat to get to the line. Okay, so this car should be set up to win that race now. Just run the stock livery for the moment, actually. Completely wrong part of the world. So we will start on hards. Cards. Wind this box out. Make it a 400 box. There we go. Let's see what happens this time. So what's been happening, Jack? Are you playing Gran Turismo? You've been doing daily races. What's your racing movements? Are you interested in the Spa 24 hour? Got to get a team together for that. I think it's only 2 months away, so probably have to start organizing that. Yeah, now we're talking. Who bought a Group 3 car? A Group C fight? I don't know what I was thinking. I was thinking I love the pain, probably. very ambitious in there. Keep an eye on that radar. The end of lap 2, it reckons. They're already making some headway. That's a good start. They even turn the fuel down. So who's the, is it Laz is lucky or the Ferbs is the lucky guy with all these wins coming around? So I think Laz has gone from being a perennial fourth place player to winning an IMSA Enduro, a Nürburgring Enduro, and what else? Did you win a third Enduro recently? I'll have to sign him up to the 24 hour. I feel like this radar's not accurate enough. It needs to be like corner per corner. It needs to be like this view, or maybe this view, but with rain, so you can get in there nitty gritty and see where the rain is, because otherwise it just turns the whole track the wrong color. Oh, that bloke's very ambitious. Hey, mate. Yeah, didn't he? What? Just absolutely threw it in there with no disregard for human life. A quiet night on the tools tonight, that's for sure. I must have the world's longest first gear. Okay, so we made some headway on the leaders that lap, so it could be good signs for the 24 minutes. Can't believe we've had to do it a second time. Oh, look, there's my favourite car, I think. Beautiful piece of kit. If I can stay on the road. There we go, getting a sweet pen just for looking at the CLK GDR. Mark Webber's favourite car. Absolutely loves it. Loves doing flips in it. Very trendy Mark Webber and flipping cars. So the weather radar not telling me that there's going to be rain at the end of this lap. I'm not sure whether we should just assume there's going to be more rain. We had more room at the top of the gearbox. that another German manufacturer. The Mercedes versus Porsche versus, oh, that, I thought that was a different car. That's the McLaren. What was I thinking of? I'm thinking of the BMW, the late 90s. Is it late 90s? Mid 90s. The hard's lasting a lot better than the soft's did, that's for sure. This car a lot more up to pace. It's funny that they've brought in the penalties to the regular gameplay too. That's interesting. Porsche curves. Pretty sure these are Porsche curves anyway. If they're not, let me know. Oh, look. Couple of rocket ships. There's absolutely nothing on the radar, nothing even near the radar. If this lap starts raining on me, I'll be so upset. Game does look very good at night though, apart from the forgetting to turn the headlights on of the cars that you overtake. Oh no, rookie life, come on, get back on. Don't tell me there's a bit of moisture around, or is that just operator error? Looks like it was operator error. What a shit truck. Yeah, tell me about it. Definitely. Welcome to the chat room, Daniel. How you been, mate? How's work treating you this fine Monday? Look how bright those red lights are. Oh, is that the rain? Can we make it to the pits, or is it going to be the same problem as last time? So we just got caught out in this particular race. So we've made it a bit further along before it rains, thankfully. Yeah, not too bad. My mouth's really dry for some reason. So, trying to work out what's going on there. Trying to get through the sun is also rising. Yeah, I just went and had a look. We definitely need to almost start a Tuesday night stream as well, I think. Cars look like they're changing over Tuesday nights now. Persona 5 Strikers. Oh no. What a rookie. So what's that about? Is that a shoot 'em up game? Gonna crucify me. How come the computer can do it? Haha. Sounds like I should know about it. Oh. Back down to 7th after all that hard work. funny how it cuts those or cuts those lights in and out. I thought it was a great choice, mate. Don't tell me I should have taken the Tomahawk. I was thinking 787B because that was a favorite. I can't remember what year I started using that. Sour was a bit deadly. If we can, if I can hold more of that. Sorry, bro. Did that for the team, I'm sure. Toyota? Ah, you've been talking to Chris too much, mate. That Toyota talk. I'd bring out the 92C. I think it's a 92C, is it? I'd bring out the Nissan, but bringing out a Toyota's, I just had to use something I already owned. We don't want to be buying cars. We're back down to 41 seconds off the leaders. Hopefully my wet weather pace is a bit better. Chris Noble, he was in the chat the other day ragging on Nissans. Bloody Nitro got him good with a 300 second no comment. Super funny. Hopefully the entrance is here somewhere. Okay, we'll go the intermediates. Yeah, Noble. Everyone else on to inter... Oh, one of those blokes went on to softs. What does he know that we don't? Shit. Yeah, I saw you in that group chat. So you've been playing a little bit of sport? You've been doing a little bit of sport things here and there? Yeah, nothing but wheel spin around here. I've got my engine turned down. I even turned traction control on. So what were you saying about it? Like it's, cause are you on a PS5 as well? Just not that crash otter. Okay, so I was about 28 seconds off the leaders. Yeah, that's about when I was in that chat. Some people come and go, and I've stayed in it because that's like my only, that was one of my original connections to meeting some local fellas. Like being new to New Zealand, I was like, oh, I need to meet some locals. Do you know what Matt's up to? Have we already talked about that? He's been really quiet, hasn't he? Be able to race full pelt. Yeah, me neither. I have a feeling we talked about it once. He must be flat out with work or something. So we chopped a good amount of time out of him then. I think this is my chance. I think the AI drives pretty average on wet. Well, sport always had room for improvement. We had all hoped it would all come with 7, but it looks like they're not actually interested in the sports side of the game at the moment. I think it will come with time, but they've just got to finish the game first, I think. Weird, the car feels very slippy, but also it feels like it's got grip. hopefully the fuel economy. It'd be me, mate. I'm a fanboy. I'm a Gran Turismo fanboy. It's so funny when I like on Reddit and stuff, you read, oh, so and so jumps in and they all love it. They're all just Gran Turismo 7 fanboys. It's like, I'm a Gran Turismo fanboy, but also know there's plenty of room for improvement. Oh, we're not making the inroads that I thought I would on the Inters. Got it down to 20 something seconds there for a little bit. Hopefully these Porsche curves are better for me. Are you talking about like Nismo, Nath? Yeah, just because it's fun and you play it doesn't mean it has to be the best. Like, I was actually really interested to see whether I'd come back and play this, actually. So I thought there would be, like, a solid chance I'd never come back. And you still come and play 7. That's, I mean, that's what it says about it. I was thinking of something there. Yeah, like, hopefully they can just grow this game. Hopefully there's enough scope in it that they can just really, like, really add the cars. Like, if they can get this up to 700 cars, I reckon that would be a really good place. They could split sport out of the game and make it like Fortnite Battle Royale or Modern Warfare, what's it called? Like the Call of Duty ones where they split the sport side out and then there's a bunch of developers that just look after that and then like leave the game as a game rather than trying to work on both things at once. I'm really going to lose this race, aren't I? It's sad. Warzone, yeah, that's the one. Why am I losing? There's only 6 minutes to go and I've not made any head road. We're gonna have to be the first guy onto slicks too, I think. That's my chance. Any good? That's one thing I need to get up and running, an Xbox. I need to like give the Forza a try it again. Last played, the most Forza I played was like the early ones, but I played up to 6, but I only played like probably 1 or 2 hours on 6. Did a fair bit on 5. Yeah, that's why I'm hoping for more Forza Motorsport 8. I was thinking like Forza could definitely just like get the list of things that people complain about on Gran Turismo and do that as their motorsports version of their game. Like what, they could probably leave Forza Horizon as their like onboarding game. And then they could pretty much make Forza Motorsport all about online competition, probably. Oh, this is frustrating. Gonna be two more laps, huh? Two laps, I think, so we'll just go softs. Softs in a full tank and just blast it. So I think we'll be seven left. You don't reckon eight will come? Like, I'm more and more thinking that eight will just be like Gran Turismo Sport. Just an online lobbies, online cars. It only has 100, 200 cars. Everything's as good as they can make it. Can't believe I'm going to lose. Okay, so we're going to come back at the end of the stream and do this race if I lose, because I've had enough of it already. Go, mate. Oh, this might even be the last lap, it reckons. Oh, no. So which Toyota? Do I need the TS50? Is that what you're saying? Love stem. What's going on, bro? Nah, because I think they were just biding their time to see what Gran Turismo do and then just make sure it's better than that. Damn, I don't even know how to cheat to win this. I honestly don't. So you won IMSA the other day as well. So you on a winning high. Got a feeling I'm not going to make it around by the... So there's only 50 seconds to the race. Sleepy Mondays. Yeah, and whatever chance I did have is completely gone. Not even gonna get a podium. That's sad. Well, a quick stream is off turning into a long stream if the half an hour challenge I can't even win. But it looks like I do need to do 3 minute 20 laps. So I was thinking I could probably win if I could just do 3 minute 30 laps. Because they were doing 3 minute 40 laps last race. Looks like you need intermediates on the second lap, whether you like it or not. So the 24 minutes is up. Why didn't he just cross the line? Are they all gonna pit or something? Serious. Oh, I'm so angry at this race. This is an hour I've just pumped through. To lose it twice. Should have just taken the Tomahawk and be done with it. Whew. I Okay. So we need a car that can do 1:20 around there. I mean, 3:20. Thought that car would have been prime for it, but apparently not. More cone challenges. What is it? 1:40. And it's weird how it bounces the car out of the way as well. Minute 40 around here, that's pretty slow, isn't it? I think. I don't know, bro. Oh, I hate that. Which lap is it? It's only that thingo lap, isn't it? Oh, we're halfway. Seconds to go. Come on. Come on. Oh no. I missed it. That's the last place I wanted to miss one. Yeah, we should be Napski Mondays. Is it the same song? No, so we got something different this time. Oh, it sounds like their song's just for this challenge, mate. Come on. So remember to brake for that one. I was trying to carry a lot of speed. Oh, I hate that when the cone goes under the car. Speaking of cones, the cones are gone, mate. The cones as a driving aid are gone. We need them back. They need to be in the very next update. I think we're a bit quicker this time. Definitely kept it a lot more pinned. Oh no, these barking cones bouncing you out of the way. That's so annoying. Yeah, we got another one. Yeah, that's what I mean. The cones were good. They just needed to make them so they don't move. They should just make them concrete cones, mate. You hit them. Like, how good was Spa when Spa first got released and it had the movable, like, the plastic slap down things you could actually slap down, you know, those bollards on Spa at a few of the corners? They got like three bollards in the middle. Well, I believe in IRL they're slap down bollards, so you can just like the plastic ones on the side of the road, if you've ever decided to stop your car and check the bollards on the side of the road. Yeah, so when Spa first came out in GT Sport, you could smash them down and they'd bounce the car. And then in the next update, they got rid of it. It was like, can't we just have any realism? Every little bit of realism, the game gets installed. Someone pisses and moans, and it gets taken away. I bet you that's why cones aren't in it. I bet you someone pissed and moaned, like, oh, the cones, they hit the car, and the car bounces. Well, don't hit the friggin' cones then. Oh no, we got 10 seconds. I'm not sure I've got enough time. No, no fun. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and failed. Doing. So we're gonna find half a second. That bloke polishes me. Oh, see, just one little bounce like that, that can ruin your whole run. Much easier to do in bumper view, this one, for sure. So I'd say that's the 0.6 we're looking for. Getting this first go would be the dream, I reckon. Oh, this would be cool. Hate to be the guy setting up all the cones though. Come on. Gotta find half a second. I think that should be well and truly over half a second. Oh, lovely. Now we're talking about dealing with the music is the actual challenge. Yes. Chris, welcome to the chat room, mate. How's your day, mate? Still grinding? Oh, apparently 35's not even that fast. Blokes are doing it twice as quick as that. Well, thankfully that's out of the way. Yeah, this update's made the cars so much more controllable. Ooh, I'm definitely just using the Tomahawk because we can't do this more than once. Oh, my time's even not too bad. Don't ask me why. Smash that GDR to pieces. Actually, I got some water. Tomahawk is unstoppable. I think that's what I did on the other one, the Le Mans 20. Oh, check it out. Look at that. Flying, bro. P1. P1, Lewis. P1. Gotta start making some money. We had 12 million before the start of this. I bet you we'll have under 10 million. Was this one difficult? Feeling it might be. 1 minute. 1 minute of pain. Ooh. Oh, one of my favorite tracks too. That was a bit hairy. Yeah, crazy. Isn't it a 3-speed? Oh, bro, why'd you go to that line? Shaping up to go to the outside every time. And then he swaps back to the inside. Good bloke. Okay, so I'm thinking of a Group 1 car that brakes at the edge of that curb. That's clearly not the braking point. Got that wrong just a touch. Beat that off nicely. I turned the mistake into a look like that's what I was trying to do. Yes. I think I'm learning how painful this is. Come on. Just keep it pinned or what? Oh no, apparently. Just keep thinking of faster cars. You just keep it pinned through there. You're just like, yep, little flick, easy peasy. Looks like this rocket ship wants to slow down to go around corners. I thought it was sucked to the ground. I thought that was the whole purpose. Isn't this a ground effects car? Like it sucks itself to the ground? Oh, 25 bites at the cherry. Oh, this is... Come on, relax. All I need to do is probably slow down and let the car do the work, but I keep thinking, I've got to catch that car. I think this is... Move across on me, bro. Oh, I had plenty of time. Why was I in such a rush? Such a rookie. Just in a rush to get the overtakes done. I thought I had to have that overtake done before the U-turn for some reason. So, no need to even break a sweat. Back over 11 mil. Hopefully we get some decent cars for this. Drifting, so if it's anything, like how bad were we at drifting the other day? It was terrible, wasn't it? So what do we got to get? 5,000 points. I like how Hyperdrift is up there. Yeah, this is hard. Okay, got to bronze at least, so it's a start. I got a feeling we need to do some six skid in the first part. Okay, so I think we need 2,000 through the first one. 3,000 through the second one. Maybe it's not like that. What are we... So we've got to find another 1,000 points, so we need 500 more in each one. Oh, 30's good. That felt like it was going to be all right, but it wasn't. Too much limiter. Dude, I need the sidewaysness in this first bit. As soon as you back off through there, it spits you off the track. I went to a drift thing once and they never came off the limiter. I bet you it's like, what have I seen? I've seen people do, just those little ones where they do this for extended periods of time. I got a decent score on the first half, so we need to find an extra 200 points in the first bit and get it back to a... Oh, close. Yeah, would you believe it or not, I'm out of skill rather than not trying to do that. I am trying to get a nice apex. Something like that was what I was trying to do. That was probably the closest I got to what I was attempting to do. What other views can you watch on? Oh yeah, this one. Did it actually look like it ripped a skid? This is the question. Zoom out, bro. Just the transition there was the bit that sort of lost it. A few little straightens up on the exit, but not terrible. So what are you gonna? Oh, so the bloke that was in the chat the other night loves a bit of drifting. He's P1 there. Ah, what was his name? Good on you, mate. Out there grinding it. Not as I found the Daytona drifting twice as hard. One lap magic, and then a race. Sickular. Yeah. I guess it's just like anything, mate. You do a few runs, you eventually remember what you're trying to do. 919. These are my pet hate challenges. They really are. Then you make one mistake and you sit here. So what do we got to sit here? 70 seconds before we get to go. Yeah. And then I think even, oh no, nah, might not be this one. There's some stupid challenge. The last car goes, and then you got to sit here for 40 seconds. It's like, what are you doing, mate? So, Daniel, you haven't told me what Toyota do I need for the 24 Le Mans. I think I have a feeling I did it in a Tomahawk on sports softs or something once, or sports hards maybe. Oh, 15 seconds, here we go. Time for some limiter launching. And then try not to run in anyone. Just 4 minutes, 3 minutes of... Yeah, that's what I said at the time. Porsche. Already feel like I'm being too conservative. Not exactly sure where all my track limit penalties and stuff are and what I lose. Yeah, I didn't want to be doing no restarts for like crossing the white lines or anything silly like that. Nine 6.2 is pretty quick. Very quick, actually. Bloke's gonna stay wide, isn't he? Bastard. Getting in my way. Come on, you good thing. 40 seconds to the leader. Already used a minute of track time. 2 minutes left. 962 is absolutely destroying us. It's found its legs. This thing accelerates like nothing else. Jump in for the GT block. He blocks me. You know, it's a little bit slower than a Toyota. I was trying to make that race interesting because I thought it would be so easy that I would just get it, you know what I mean? Turns out trying to make the race interesting is not good for your health. Oh, I slowed down at the wrong point. Thank God, that was only a one take. I was getting a bit worried. I thought just as I touched that bloke, I'm like, I'm gonna get the restart here. It's gonna be like, restart. Ding ding. Now the Jaguar. How long's this race? Is it another 30 minute race? All the 20 minutes of Bathurst. Everybody knows this is my favorite track. Come on. No fuel strats by the looks of it. Maybe some tire strat. Oh, there is fuel. Make sure we... Yeah, gonna keep that bad boy in one. Pretty throaty, the old Jag. Shady move over the mountain, what do you reckon? Get the Alpha as well. Way too much concentrating over the top of the mountain. What do you reckon of the McLaren white livery? Oh, which way are you going, mate? Funny how they put two liveries on a lot of the cars this time. Instead of just getting you one factory livery, you got like one factory livery and an alternate. Maybe not on every car, but on a couple of cars I've noticed. Maybe the 100 meter. I've noticed sometimes you get away with braking at the 75 meter mark down there, which is extremely late in my opinion. Same here. I think the 24, was it the, no, it was a 12 hour race at Bathurst, wasn't it, that we did? I think that's helped me a lot to finally learn. I spent so many hours over those few weeks trying to learn my way around here. Traditionally a bogey track for me, struggled here a lot. Only you could run a wall like that in real life, eh? I wouldn't be game enough. Coming through here, I'd be shitting my pants, I reckon. Oh. Oh, easy as you like around the outside. Bit messy. Down to 10 seconds, what are we, just a couple of laps in. Evo pulls out late. No, pulls back in. See, that's another alt livery. Must be like for different drivers. There must be like two drivers in the game that represented that manufacturer, and it's like, oh, we can't make them, put them in the same car in the same race. We may as well make them alt liveries, and they can both be in the game together. That's what I reckon, because I think one of them is the Japanese driver, and the other one is Hazel for the Subarus. Don't know about the McLarens. The McLarens were running different liveries as well. It looks like we're smashing through the tires already. Cheekiest move I've ever done, I reckon. Even if it was AI, I tried to keep it clean. Just to see if it could be done. Lovely light wall tap. Looks like it's gotten greasy up here. Road's got a bit of a sheen to it. The Aston should give us a nice big toe. I like how the cars move around, they get squirrely under braking. Actually, good addition. The old days of the car used to stay in a straight line. Just Morris. Marginal fuel burn gains by the looks of it with all these purples. I started understeering as soon as I turned in. I just couldn't talk myself into backing out. AMG. How good does the AMG look in this version of the game? I watched Portimao on the weekend. The qualifying, I think. The DTM. These cars look so good. Like the AMGs. Sick Bilstein AMG too. The livery I'll have to mock up when I get a chance. Nitro hasn't heard me talking about AMGs and magically appeared into the chat room. Okay, I'm confused. I'll pre-confuse myself. Yes, I'm confused. That is interesting. Did they have a public holiday of some importance, or are they going full American spec and starting midweek racing? We're not even half race distance, are we? Already into first. Yep. They didn't want to miss their race weekend, so they postponed it to the week. Oh, 1 week. How cool is that? After this stream, I'll have to look it up on me. On me Motorsport TV. That fuel burn must be heavy. I have access to it. I have a service where they've chucked Motorsport TV in with it. Oh, really? I might be out of luck then. Might be plumb out of luck. What other stuff does it have on it? Does it have Super Formula as well? These tires. Yep. And you just run that as an app on your phone? Because for me, it was inside a service that I used, and I had to go in there, log on, and then look at it in the browser, and then I had to remember it was on. I always forgot that I had it. So I never went in there and checked it, ever. Like, twice I probably remembered it, and then I just put my TV on permanently. If it was on my phone, I would actually remember that I have it. This is a 20-minute endurance, isn't it? So we're gonna do 10 laps of this. Thought that might have been a bit harder. Ah, that's no good. Maybe the challenge was not to use all the tire. Definitely slippery now. Yeah, Bathurst has been the bane of evil for me. I've just been really, really bad at it. One track I've never really came to terms with. And I just did the Bathurst. Oh, this was a good lap that I just binned. That was another purple lap. Yeah, then I just did the iRacing Bathurst 12 hour. And I was meant to do a 12 hour either the week before or the week after that. Like an Australian sim racing 12 hour as well. Alex, how are you, mate? Yeah, no, we're on controller at the moment. So I don't know if you're just brand new here or you've been a lurker for a while, but I play cockpit view. I'm a cockpit view Gran Turismo Sport. I want to say specialist, but it's not the right word. Player. I do all my racing in cockpit view with the steering wheel, but as that we're not in sport mode and I'm playing casually, I'm casually on controller. So yeah, we do have all the rig and all the bullshit, but we're just doing some casual Gran Turismo 7 playthrough at the moment. Leaving the sport mode stuff for a little bit. We will be back on it once we finish all the single player stuff. We are just going through it nice and easy at the moment. We are running out of content though, so we will have to swap back to daily races and the such. I'm not sure. I would really love to get back into like the World Tour side stuff, but the earliest race for me is at 9 p.m. and I don't get up super early, but I get up early enough that 9 p.m. is past my wind down time. And there's only Nations Cup available at 9 p.m. Yeah, playing out of New Zealand means all the time slots are no good for us. Unless, of course, you have a regular day job. With, like, if you had a day job that you start at 9 a.m., you could probably set up. Like, it wouldn't be too bad for you, I guess. But, unfortunately, I don't have that luxury. You start early too, don't you, Daniel? Yeah, they did have it early at one stage because that's how my channel started. Cheers, Sleep Sound. We've had a couple of lurkers pop out since the GT7 gameplay. Thanks for chucking a comment in there, mate. Hopefully this race is almost over. What do you think of the difference between like playing super serious and playing casual on controller? Like I sort of, yeah, this channel really started sort of as a FIA Nations Cup sort of channel. No, was it Nations Cup? What was it? Manufacturers, I think. I think I used to do both. I used to run them alternately, and they used to start at about 4 or 5 in the afternoon. Perfect timing for someone like myself. So yeah, we would have maybe done a whole season or two. We've become a much better driver since then, though. I think I was still a C and B grade driver back then. Still didn't really understand how to drive as much as I do these days. Looksy? That's alright. Oh, no. That's the wrong one. You don't have to do that. Just hold your finger on the screen till the timer counts down and that'll do. Sweet. Oh. Yeah, where were we?
Yeah, I'd love to get. I want to like email PD and tell him, seeing as that it's meant to be serious and you're not meant to multi-slot the racing, they should have 2 hour gaps in between the races and start them heaps earlier. So they could probably start at 4 p.m. New Zealand time, then a 2 hour slot, then 6, 8, 10, 12, and then a lot more people would have a race in their time zone. Rather than just this one race every hour for 5 hours and half the time zones in that region don't get a race. But I know, like, they are the most populated region, so we should probably have to suffer the most, but just is unfortunate. Cheers, mate. Yeah, like, this is fairly cash. we have done fairly well on the wheel in the past, but we were playing a lot at that stage. Like, so I would have been pumping out, and this still puts you a couple of seconds off, like, the region's better players, or race time was. Yeah, I would be doing at least 2 hours a day. And then, like, I used to make, like, lap guide videos and stuff. So, yeah, I'd do probably about 200 kilometers. Try and make get a decent lap in. One of the things I've always lacked is practice and race times, like for the FIA. I never practiced for that. Now I wish I had of. But yeah, daily races was my specialty. I was lucky enough to, on my American account, race one of the South American top players. And I lost to him by 3 seconds. And, yeah, it was crazy. Like, the amount, like, the... I would have done almost my perfect race, and he just destroyed me. But... oh, thankfully that's over. Ah, cheers, mate. Yeah, like, I'm trying to be, like, there was a time there where it was like, oh, every lap has to be about this, and the channel has to be about me improving and helping other people improve, which, that helps you, like, find new people. And so I do like doing the, yeah, that's probably way too small to be able to see. Yeah, so I did, I don't know, I must have done 100 GT Sport lap guides or more, and then started trying to do some iRacing ones. I really got into that, but that's a time sink. Like, that game gets really, really in-depth, really fast. It's hard to be a casual player. Like, with Gran Turismo, you can really be a casual player and a casual decent player, if that makes any sense. So we didn't gold one of these, so we're going to have to go back and do it for the third time. Just going to see if I own this Toyota. I don't think I do. Looks like we're going to go and have to waste some cash. But yeah, I would love to, like, in my ideal world, I would like have enough time to sit there and grind iRacing to the extent that I grind Gran Turismo Sport. Because we learnt a lot about driving, just like pumping through heaps of podcasts and books on driving and driving techniques, trying to maximize the small amount of time I have to play. And I can confidently say you don't have to try and rush to be a fast driver. Took me about 2-3 years to learn. We will get there shortly, Daniel. TS 51 million dollars. Oh, do they have the driver? Normally they have the driver list for both of these cars. Where can we see the... Wrong one. We need to see the driver's names. Buemi. Yeah, we'll take the one with Kobayashi in it. And then we'll duck over to have a look at today's new dailies. I was thinking, in my mind, that thing would have been done in under an hour, and we would have jumped over and done a couple of dailies, Daniel. Couple of controller dailies. That was a lot of fun the other day doing. Jeez. Doing those daily race A's on controller was, yeah, now that I've had time to reflect, heaps of fun. Suzuka, 5 laps. The daily race A. And the force feedback on these has been a little bit weird. Wait, and where's the borrower car? Ah, so there's clearly two cars. 5 laps. Sure, it can't be full Suzuka. It's going to have to be Suzuka East. Am I missing something somewhere? Okay, let's just... go have a look. Specified car, enter. Oh no, we don't want to enter it. We want to do qualifying. Okay, we just have to look at the qualifying time ranking. That'll tell us how big it is. Fire. I think have they stuffed up? 5 laps, 2.5 minutes. That's 10 minutes. That's 15 minutes. That's a 15 minute race A. I mean, that's a good thing. But it also means slow drivers won't be able to finish. If you're doing 3 minutes a lap around there. What's, oh no, 5.3s are 15. Oh, am I on drugs or what? Yeah, so even 3 minutes a lap, you should still finish the race. Yeah, don't ask me what I was tripping on. So Lester's been busy. What's he doing? You should be in bed, mate. Haha. Memes. And Daily Race C, which is generally the only one we do. Group 2 at Fuji. We might actually have to bust out the wheel this week and do this, I think. Maybe that can be our job. Lester never sleeps, you don't reckon? No, he mustn't, mate. It's funny, some of these players. Like, if you want to get your name on the wank board, which is, yeah. You just got to make sure you start your first lap as soon as they change over. Quickly get your name on the board, screenshot. Yeah, this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking we might actually, this might be our first daily races back. I might actually grind that out tomorrow. Grind out a lap time, see how we go. I love Group 2 cars. So Nations Cup is coming, round 1. So did anyone see if we press enter? One, two, three, four, five, six. Six time slots. Is this an accident that it's got the second? Because it's got the same time twice. Those that just the five time slots. Did anyone else notice that? Can race at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, midnight, or 1 a.m. or 9 o'clock. And Dragon Trials Seaside. It was actually getting me tempted. I was like, oh, maybe I should dust the steering wheel off, and Dragon Trail should be a lot of fun. Ah, okay. That's more like it. The six times. Ah, okay. So that's round two. If I click on that, so Yodes has actually clicked on it. Ah, that is awesome. That's a really good idea. That give you the starts in 5 days entry period. Oh yeah, that's cool. That's a good idea. A good idea. So what happened to manufacturers? Where's that gone? They only did one round, and now it's gone. So is this a one round event as well? Do tell, do tell. I'm gonna have to go and modify. Actually, we've got daily spins to do. We've got a couple of viewers. We'll crank down the spins while everyone's here. We'll start on these. Awesome. Look at all the one stars. Last week we spun a six star. So 29th of the 5th. That's the oldest, crappiest one we've got. Oh, for a moment there, I thought I wasn't gonna get. Next shitty one. Shitty part town. Lovely. And now some exotic two stars, mate. Two stars. Give us one of them big bars. No, small stack again. So what's that? Four smaller stacks in a row? And this will be the fifth smallest stack in a row. Heard it here first. Oh, that could be my first chance at an engine. No, got a block instead. OMG. Just vault. Oh, maybe I can trade this one to Laz. Laz would love a Sirocco upgrade. Four up S. Oh, well. That was fairly uneventful. So at the end of the second lap, whether we like it or not, yeah, me too. So I can't even upgrade my big turbos. Sadness. Gamble your way up to 2 grand. Money bags. So I really can't put a better turbo on this. That's sad. Sad noises. Those dailies look really good, I think. I don't know what my plans are for the rest of the week, but I could see myself doing Fuji. So pit after lap two, whether we like it or not. No, wrong one. Rookie life. Okay, the 24 minutes of. And then we can go back. Did you. G'day, Yoda, how are you? Did you upgrade your. So we're just gonna pit after two laps, aren't we? Just so nervous. I don't want to do this a tenth time. Held settings. Ah, that's right. That's what I noticed. They always do the combos. Not always. They a lot of the race C combos are. They do the super formula. Like when it's at Fuji, they'll have super formula Fuji. When the GTs are there, they'll do put the GTs there. When there are auto pods and Suzuka and all that week is when they run the when those run those kind of races. I'm just gonna hope we'll just go flat out on softs. Pit for inters at the end of lap two, I think. Whether I like it or not. I need to be pulling 3 minute 20 lap times, I think. For sure. They do, they seem to align a lot of those events. They would definitely have Group 1 at La Sarthe on the Le Mans week, which I think is in a couple of weeks. So, how many inroads we can make. Come on. It looks like I've run out of battery management already. Have to throw that on. Hit me on the radar, but. Really? So Yodes's got a Nürburgring trip that he's got to get back on the cards. I'm saying the next time I go to Germany, I'm definitely doing the Nordschleife. This race is not looking too good for me again, Daniel. Have you sold me up the creek, mate? I'm not making any inroads to the leaders. No inroads have been made. There's still 40 seconds in front of me. So, are you using the same tickets of like the promoters had you had it already locked in, and this is why you're going next year? No, this year. What did you say? Next year. Got a refund. Oh, bro, parked on the apex. What are you doing? So we made no inroads, mate. I'm still 35 seconds off the leaders. Even with me super strat. I knew that was going to be a bloody track limit. Oh, need to rum him wide. Did you get refunds too? I'd love to be money bags and just do the RSR Nürburgring and then. And then Spa. 2 weeks in a row, that would be mega. Yeah, you should do it. Oh, how was that, Alex? Really good? That thing's got some poke in a straight line. So we're gonna pit for Inters at the end of this. Yeah, Le Mans, or no, you don't. nothing better. Like, I'm an Aussie living in New Zealand, but my first GP was the 2010 Australian GP. So back under the V8s. Mate, what are you doing? And it was, yeah, listener, spine-tingling listener F1 cars for the first time was just really something else. Yeah, I've heard Miami is, apparently over 300,000 people put their name down for tickets. Still 37 seconds off, Daniel. What have I done wrong, mate? So this is the world's biggest gamble. I'm going to go to intermediates at the end of this lap. Intermediates, maybe no fuel. I don't know, confused. But we'll maybe fill it up, run fuel one. Might go to Texas. Like, you're gonna go to Texas this year? That would be awesome. If money and time permits. That would be pretty cool. Instead of miss out on one GP and get tours on special. So now watch the game realize I've gone to intermediates and not rain. I can see it here. I can just feel it in the stars. But every other time I've done this, it rains in lap two, and then I get caught short and die. So what we could do to take some bite out of the tire, maybe lean off that map. Five laps remaining. interesting. 5 laps, that's 15 minutes. That means we should have enough fuel for the race. No rain coming. I knew it. It's going to be a dry race. Oh no, there's the rain. I really need to be eating into that lead now. Funny thing is, I've won this race on the other profile, but God knows how I did it. So there's 4 laps to go, so we should be good for fuel, I think. Unless it's get the Tomahawk out. Bloody track limits. They're killing me. I'm getting so lazy. I'm so used to just cheating against the AI. It's now nearly strong enough for wets. Yeah. That's annoying. So we lost 15 seconds moving to the tyre early, and now it's raining so hard it's wets. I don't know what the strat is. Like, rains to the end, I'm sure of it. Yeah, tell me about it. Yeah, not in this particular race. Like, I have used them somewhere. In a race. Was that lightning? That's cool if that was just lightning. Now we're back out. Oh, you're kidding me. Yeah, tell me about it. Yeah, so what do you reckon? Hards to wets. And then I crawl around for half a lap waiting for it to rain. Like, I have a feeling I did street tires in a Tomahawk to pass it. Yeah, cheers. We saved a few of them. But yeah, we couldn't. Didn't get the job done in the end. It's, yeah, tell me about it, 3 Mile. We're back into inter territory. But I'm now losing more than I was before. And the cars that I'm racing are doing the same lap times as me. So I need a car that's considerably faster than them. And that is just not this car at this point in time. And I keep going and getting penalties. They were back down into inters. Maybe I was just meant to slow down. Yeah, cheers, Dio. I definitely need it, mate. It's been a frustrating race because I'm sure, like, I didn't want to bring the Tomahawk out. Like, I was like, just take the Tomahawk out on street tires and absolutely destroy everyone. I just don't know if I'm not driving fast enough. You know it, mate. Get the Tomahawk out, do 600 kilometers down the back straight and win. Doesn't matter that you're on street tires. You don't have to pit. Run fuel map 6. No stop the whole race on street tires. We've got 8 minutes left. This guy's pulling away from me. Yeah, so the 919 with the regen? You reckon it's coming towards me now, Alex? Hopefully you're right, mate. Hopefully the drying track is what I needed, but this bloke in front is struggling to catch him. So we're about to move to dries. How many laps did I say there is left? So 3 minutes. So 1, 2, maybe a third. We'll bump that up to fuel map 1. See if it makes much difference. And we'll do the fuel management late if we have to. Come on. Down to 30 seconds. We need 10 seconds on him on the lap. Come on. TS 30, move out of the way. Outside should become the inside. There needs to be a point where the track changes as I'm about to enter the pits. And it seems to be the changing conditions is where the AI struggles the most. So they're starting to pump it back up, 33 seconds now. Oh, he's going to push me out of the way. How rude. What is it? There's two laps to go, hopefully. I've got a feeling this might be the wrong choice, but we've got to try it. We've got to do something different. Hopefully there's a dry line back out there when we jump out. Yeah, two laps, hard tires. I'm hoping everyone comes in and gets their soft tires. Oh, what are you doing? Go. Stay on the straight and narrow. Yeah, it's definitely dry now. So where are they? They're a minute ahead of me. So they've got 2 minutes worth of dry track to use on an intermediate tire. I really have to make hay while the sun shines. 3 minutes, so we're gonna get one extra lap, hopefully. Gonna be dependent on not making any mistakes, staying off the curbs. Yep. Come on. I gotta get the rub of the green eventually. Taking on fuel was definitely a mistake. Oh, mate. You'd just die, wouldn't you? Oh, they're at the Porsche curves. Track is just about dry. Even better yet, they could stay on intermediates for me so I could really catch up. Stay on inters, you know you want to. More penalties, mate. I lose so much time with those penalties. So they won't take on any fuel. So I'm gonna suffer for that. or wet curb like a boss. Oh, was that the... Oh, that hurts. That's clearly not that car. I'm clearly doing something wrong. What are we doing wrong? And it's 20 minutes every practice go. Do I just bust out the tomahawk and call it a day? Oh, I didn't think it would be that difficult. So we've got Tomahawk, Red Bull competition. So it's an open slather. Probably even put the Living Legend back on good tyres. I can't even remember what that's like when you put decent tyres on it. Like, that's tuned up to 920 pp and couldn't get the job done. That's 900 as well. I mean, the Tomahawk's definitely going to do it. We could probably get out the F-150. Do you reckon that's fast enough? You'd hope so, wouldn't you? Pity none of these took. If you do. So I'm allowed to use the Tomahawk if I don't use any assists. Like if I don't turn traction control on. Is that what you're saying, Yoda? Let me know. Otherwise. Because the Toyota couldn't be tuned anymore. The Porsche is on max tune. I haven't even had a look at that F1500. We've got the XJ9 787s. I mean, we've got cars in here that should smash this home. It shouldn't be that hard. So we're racing it. Look, TS30 hybrid, it reckons, is me main rival car. Do whatever I like. Just waiting for those chat comments to come through as we do some fill. Other than that, yeah, the top speed, like a. What's a car that used to do 400? Like, I thought this Porsche used to do 400. Because I'm just pumping through the money. We started it. Yes, fair enough. Yeah, that's what I thought you meant, but I was hoping you meant we could just go and finish it. See, even this bad boy can't get it. Oh, how big's this turbo? See, same deal. Just takes us to 900 horsepower. Like, or just go back and do the Porsche. Because we had the Porsche, but what was I doing wrong in the Porsche? We didn't have any... we had the top speed, but we didn't have... I couldn't rev it out, and I can't see whether I'm revving it out. I'm sure this wheel's turned on. But I can't see anything in the bottom of the screen, so I couldn't see what gear we were getting in. So if we go to the Porsche... Car settings... Like, if I dial that back to 370, maybe? Maybe pull all the aero out of it? gonna make it pretty hard to drive. I think I've got nitrous. Start on softs as well, so we can do it. Okay, so we'll go back to the tuning room. This stream is turning into an awfully long stream all of a sudden. Okay, did we buy nitrous? Yes, we bought nitrous. We've got wets, we've got everything. We've got... So we can do... So maybe just no fuel saving. We'll just go softs, flat out. I've got all the tires for this thing. Got the racing transmission. Don't know why it's so hard. None of this is applicable. Yeah. So the only other thing I can think of is go road tires and don't pit at all, do a no stop. But I think the car burns too much fuel. So this Porsche's got to be quick enough. I'm just really lacking something. I'm lacking in skill. Yeah, so we've stripped all the downforce off. Up the nitrous. Fast as we can go. Fast as we can go. So I'll do two laps flat out. Pit for inters. Two laps flat out. I need to check my top speed down the Mulsanne. If I'm getting the top speed wrong, we're just leaving power behind. I need to rev this bad boy out, because I think that's where I'm going to make all the speed. Right. Got 900 horsepower. Should fly down the straights. She's a bit fucking airy. Yeah, this is hard to drive. You reckon go... I don't think the track's wet enough, though. So the track only goes wet for about 30 seconds, and then it's inters before and after. Okay. So how fast are we going? Oh, shit. I don't want to know how big that penalty is going to be. Funny if I get away with it. Yeah, that's what I thought it would be quick enough. Oh, every time I look away, can't look away. So we need to be making up, I need to be doing in the 20s. Don't worry about the fuel, because we're going to have to pit twice anyway, so I may as well. So we pretty much have to catch the leaders by the time the rain comes out, I reckon. Means we're going to have to be doing some mega speed, so 380 feels about right. Time looks like it's coming down nicely. The tires are cooked though. I could not pick up some penalties, that would help as well. There we go, 3:20. Anyway, we're in the zone. That's sort of the lap times that I think I have to do. Gonna be hard on this second lap. Those rear tires are cooked. Definitely punished them. Come on, you good thing. Oof. Well, pit for Inters, I think, after this lap again. I looked up at the brake boards and I was like, oh shit. I think I need to brake at the 200s. Oh, that was hardly a cut, boss. Gonna hurt too. Down to 14 seconds. So there is a chance. Some inroads now. Whoops. Come on. Damn. It's these penalties, man, I'm telling you. Intermediates, we'll take a full tank, we'll go back to fuel saving. Maybe the idea is I don't come back and change tires, because that's always on the last lap and I crucify myself. So maybe we're gonna stay out the extra lap on the inters, maybe. So maybe I'm gonna have to like really baby them. So 7 minutes, because this pit stop is a huge amount of time by the looks of it. Absolutely destroyed those tires. Night time now. Oh, cross the line, pit lane exit penalty. Try not to be aggressive on them out of the off the apex. make some headroads. Make some nice headroads in on this straight. So maybe 250 board. Looks like we lost 30 seconds spot on the pit. Rain should be here by now. Maybe it's punishing me. Yeah, it's crazy, huh? Those guys are at the Porsche curves. They should be losing a heap of time. Yeah, I thought hitting it. Pitting at Trial Mountain would be faster. I was hoping we'd get a run again at your lap time tonight, Yoda. So theoretically, I should be going around all these corners faster than they were. Come on. At least in the battle, I think. 15 seconds away. I think this is where the track's at its wettest. What a killer. It's going to be that race again, isn't it? So maybe you just have to stay on the line. Because it's when I pulled out to overtake that guy, I got absolutely murdered. Killing me. Mother flipper. Again. Not if I keep doing that. I literally can't keep it in a straight line. You know, I even know this is the 30 seconds of the race where it's really, really wet. They're already back on this half of the circuit. It's dry again. It's just the Mulsanne. I can't believe I'm gonna have to come back to this. He must be a wets, he's flying. How many minutes left? There's 9 minutes for 20 seconds. Oh no. Yeah, it's definitely an intermediate track now. Hopefully the leader was on wets. I gotta remember no fuel if we make it that far. Or maybe just don't pit, run these to death. They already feel cooked though. Come on, Porsche, come on. So tense. Mad penalties, big penalties from big cuts. I just can't help myself. I'm so used to just being AI. I'm just doing it for Yoda. He said it's not over yet. I feel as though it's long gone, but... Oh, mate, it's frustrating. Especially if I lose by a couple of seconds, mate. And my enters are cooked, but... Oh, I thought he was going to take me out. See how it's just that's I've spun out worth of 20 seconds, mate. We could have been, should have been, would have been. Lousy, how are you, mate? Could have been, should have been winning this race. I just need to not pick up silly penalties. I feel like the bloke in front is finally on the wrong tyre. So it's only a 7-lap race by the looks of it, and I'm just struggling to get that, close that gap. Rear tires are proper smoked. Yeah. It's like I keep doing silly things like spinning out. I refuse to slow down when the rain comes on. Only one lap to go. Yeah, Lousy, it's been so painful. Our old mate's gonna pit. This should be the last lap, eh? So nervous right now. I've got no grip at all. Catching me already. Yeah, but he's only 7 seconds away, and I got no grip at all, mate. I'm absolute ice skates. And I've got a penalty. Come on, shitbox. Yes, mate. I do not want to do this again. Any mistake here and I'm gone. I've got a 5 second buffer. Oh, whoops. Whoa, I was trying to look at my fuel map. I killed that guy. Oh, shit. Oh, I should have lost that at a half. Oh, that hurt a lot. I don't know what the strat should be. I think pit later. I'll have a look at the replay. That was crazy. I saw like 0.2 and I'm like, oh, I've got to get to my fuel map. I've got to roll off my fuel map. I need to be able to accelerate off the last thing. Oh shit, and it let me win. I don't know, did he get bogged in the sand or something? That was fucking outrageous. Oh, I thought I was gonna get pimped at the line. I thought I'd lost that for sure. But wait on. Plus one, how do you control this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that'd be... I assume that's him in the background. So I think that's the strat. Maybe mediums or hards and do three. Do the half a lap. Go to inters. Slow down on the Mulsanne like you should. And then fly. Yes, how good is that, mate? They needed lap jumps so much. So that was... I didn't want to win like that. I thought I'd lost. I'd already resigned to we were doing that one more time. I'm sort of glad I don't have to do it again. Ah, there he is right there. So what was it in the end? Was it a Peugeot or something? Peugeot 308 maybe. 908, sorry. I saw him like at 2.5 seconds and I'm like, oh, I have to go really slow through the Porsche curves because I've got no grip. Hopefully he just checks up and sits behind me. Porsche curves, only one line, you got to check up. Oh, I lost it. And then he's through. And that's it, I thought, oh shit, now I'm going to run out of fuel. I'm looking for my fuel map, where's my fuel map? I thought I'd hit the wall. So, what does he do? Oh, he's bogged. Where's the... So this is... That was luck if I've ever had it. Oh, he's trying to reverse. Just get bogged in the sand pit. Oh, that's hilarious. Oh. Yeah, he couldn't breathe. Old onboard. So that's it. He pits on the last lap if you don't, and that's where you get your free 20 seconds. Right now we would have thought he had it in the bag. Imagine if this was sport mode and that happened. What kind of, you wouldn't believe me that it was an accident, would you? It was a genuine accident. I was looking at my fuel thingamabob, trying to do a fuel adjustment because I needed discombobulate. I'm probably lucky you had a lift off there. Shit, I'm so glad I have to don't have to do that again. Very generous. Look at this. Just he might have given me a little tap there somewhere. Yeah, there. This is gonna look like a. Oh my god! I'm so embarrassed. I'm so embarrassed right now. Can't believe I did. Yeah, I know. Because what I was going to do, obviously when you're flying down the straight that quick, you don't have enough time. I was going to change the fuel maps and then jump the chicanes and then hopefully I didn't get a penalty. That was the plan. The plan was to, yeah, jump all the chicanes, like go like straight line all three or four of the bastards. Very, very embarrassing, that's for sure. What kind of excuse has this bloke got? Let's see what his head movements are. See if he really is looking at his fuel gauge. No, where's he looking? He never looks at his fuel gauge at all, that guy. Not even a little bit of fuel gauge. Oh, fuel light's on. He's distracted by the fuel light. That was crazy. It couldn't have worked out better, I swear. I need a thumbs up for that, please. And all the new guys, subscribe, because that is quality Gran Turismo. Only in Gran Turismo can you do that. Nowhere else in the world. I murdered the AI with no assists, like a boss. shit, what a day. I was clearly out of form. Ah, that was something else. Got to learn a new strat though, so not too bad. Ah, finally get the gold car. This would be the gold car, I guess. Don't even have time to do a circuit experience. I've already run so late. Ah, but it's done, I guess. It's done. Shit, eh? Oh, yep, so we got the BRZ. Gold, and it took me 400 kilometers. Yeah, this is it, mate. Well, that was that. So I did Skyline, Porsche, Toyota, Porsche. And that was a Hail Mary. I was almost going to have to do that a fifth time. I couldn't believe it. I thought there's no way it's going to take me more than one go to do all to do these. But yeah, thanks for everyone that put up with the pain. Is there anything we need to look at before we go? They've been really nice blokes and changed the new cars to pretty much Tuesday night. So new cars, Sports 800. Might even pick one of those up on special. Look at that. Yeah, this is it. That's a lovely car. I'm not a Toyota guy, but I'd own that. No, we do not. It's just in our car collection. Yeah. Furbsy. So, the word on the street, fellas, is we're doing Fuji. So I don't even know how we'll start off the stream on Wednesday night. Maybe we just start off in the Fuji with a group C, a daily race C stream. That would be something else. That means I'm going to have to practice using a steering wheel tomorrow. So when's the 6th? Is that a third? That's a Friday night. Doing races on Friday nights for? Everybody knows Friday night is drinking night. Nah, this is it, bro. This is what we're doing. Oh, I don't own any Group 2 cars. So, Fuji. Daily Race C, Wednesday night. Word on the streets, when's Loopy coming? I'm not too sure. Fuji Group 2. I can see it now. We'll do one race, have a great race. Do a second race, rage quit, punt some parboard. Poor bastard off, ruin his night completely. And then we'll do a third race and try and calm down and collect ourselves. And then, so who's on PS5s? Who are we going to be racing against? Because I think, unless they've changed the servers and we can race other people, she could be pretty lonely on the PS5. Legendary cars, nothing has changed up in here. Still got a Mercedes-Benz I'll never buy unless I got 13 grand square. Jag D-Type, maybe later. Didn't even bother buying the Superbird, that's interesting. Got the Porsche 962C though, got a Camaro, Porsche Spyder. Waiting for all the platinum stuff. I've got to get my platinum trophy. But yeah. Thanks everyone for putting up with that. That was mental. It was fun doing the other challenges, but that challenge in particular absolutely killed me. So I'm going to sign off and call that a night, I think. So Ferbs late in the chat. Yoda, Lounsy, thanks for hanging around. 3 Mile, mate. Oh, yes. Yeah, it's good to see you back in the chat, mate. We definitely said Lounsy, I'm sure. New chatters. Who were our new chatters? We had a new chatter back here. Alex, that's the one. Alex, thanks, mate. Thanks for swinging past. He said he's going to try and catch a few streams. Appreciate that, mate. And there was another new chatter as well, I believe. Just Dio or Dio said hi again. Daniel, thanks for hanging out, mate. Been a... solid chatter, almost lead chatter lately. Been throwing tons of comments up in there. Might have missed a few blokes early, have we? Perhaps not. Ah, Sleep Sound. That's the one. Sleep Sound, mate. Another new chatter. Cheers, mate. Yeah, I'm trying to start the streams later so that the Australians can be at home at least. Loopy was in here, Devs was in here, giving me some hassle. Chris showed up as well. Love Stem, aka the winner. Just everything he touches turns to gold. He's got the Midas touch. Jack and Ferret. Love all you fellas. Thanks for hooking me up. No, that's good. Yeah. No, like I said, that whole challenge was meant to take about 1 hour. Then we were going to do some circuit challenge. Then we were going to do maybe some daily race A. Then I was going to do this and then I was going to do that. And here we are 3 hours later. 3 hours it took me to do that. So it is what it is. But yeah, peace out, fellas. Love yous all. And I'll see you later.